Hello and welcome, dear children. Today we shall study Standard 7th English Poem number 1.3, In Time of Silver Rain, written by Langston Hughes. Langston Hughes is an American poet, social activist, novelist, and a playwright. He was born in US. At that time, the term African American was Negro, which means a person with black skin. As there was discrimination between white and black skin people, Hughes went back to West Africa to understand about his own culture. Hughes inspired people with his writing and helped and encouraged many struggling writers. He has been also awarded and honored for his writing and social work. Hughes died in New York at the age of 65. Over his ashes in the circle, with an African design called Rivers, at the center of the design are words from a poem by Hughes. My soul has grown deep like the river. Let us read one of his inspirational poems, In Time of Silver Rain. 1.3, In Time of Silver Rain. In time of silver rain, the earth puts forth new life again. Green grasses grow and flowers lift their heads, and over all the plains the wonder spreads of life, of life, of life. In time of silver rain, the butterflies lift silken wings to catch a rainbow cry, and trees put forth new leaves to sing in joy beneath the sky. As down the roadway passing boys and girls go singing too, in time of silver rain, when spring and life are new. The poet begins the poem with describing the rain as silver rain. Why is the poet calling the rain as silver rain? Perhaps because he remembers the proverb, every cloud has a silver lining. And even all of us have seen, when the raindrops shine, they look silver in color. Further, he says, when it starts raining, the earth has new life again. In India, it rains after the harsh summer season. So when it rains, the earth is smiling and is full of life. There is new life in the form of green grass growing. The poet has personified the flowers by saying that they lift their heads. Personification means human quality is given to a non-living thing. Here, human quality of lifting heads is given to the flowers. So when it rains, even new flowers bloom everywhere. He further states that it is a wonderful and beautiful sight as far as our eyes can see, as if the rain has spun a magical wand on the earth and has spread wonder all around. The poet ends the stanza by repeating the words of life, of life, of life. Here, the poet has used the figure of speech, that is, repetition, just to give emphasis on key words, that is, of life, which gives the message that the earth is full of life and everybody is happy and smiling. In the second stanza, the poet continues saying that when it rains, the butterflies fly about with their silken wings. Silken means silk-like, beautiful and shining wings. Now, what do these butterflies want to do? Yeah, they want to touch the beautiful rainbow high in the sky. Why has the poet described the rainbow as rainbow cry? Here, A rainbow symbolizes happiness. Rainbow is shedding tears of happiness while the butterflies flatter about. He further states that the trees have new leaves. Here again, the poet has personified the leaves to be singing joyfully under the beautiful sky. The poet wants to say that it is not only the earth, trees, leaves, and flowers in nature that are happy, but also boys and girls are happy. They are singing and dancing with joy and happiness. So, both nature and mankind is happy and full of life. From this poem, the poet wants to convey a message that nature and life keeps on moving ahead with all the pros and cons of life. After every bad phase of life, there is always a new hope of growth and prosperity in everyone's life. So, let's forget our past and enjoy the rain today. I hope you all have understood this poem. Now, let us see some poetic device that the poet has used. The first is rhyming words. Here we find different rhyming words that the poet has used to make this poem look more beautiful. For the first one is rain again. Second, cry sky. Third, too new. Now, second question, we see that he has used figures of speech. In the following lines, we will see what all figures of speech the poet has used. First one, of life, of life, of life. Okay, so in this sentence, he has used the figures of speech, that is repetition. Now, the second one, and flowers lift their heads. Here he has used personification. We can understand that flowers are given human quality, that is of lifting heads. So it is personification. Third one, the butterflies lift silken wings to catch a rainbow cry. Here again, he has used personification. Hope you all have understood the poetic device that the poet has used. Now, for today, your homework is to learn the poem thoroughly, okay? And you will also find other figures of speech that the poet has used. Thank you, children.